Before they were big, the Protosauropoda, the little long-necked dinosaurs. Welcome to the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Berger. I'm a paleontologist at Utah State University, teaching in the heart of Utah's dinosaur country in Vernal. In this video, we are going to begin our exploration of the lizard-hipped dinosaurs, the saurischian dinosaurs. Now, dinosaurs are divided into two large groups, the saurischian dinosaurs, the lizard-hipped dinosaurs that have a forward-projecting pubis bone, and the ornithischian dinosaurs, or bird-hipped dinosaurs, in which the pubis bone is backward-projecting. Now, there are a few other differences between saurischian and ornithischian dinosaurs besides the hip, including an extra articulation in the dorsal vertebrae and a twisted thumb on digit 1 of the hand, which is present ancestrally in early saurischian dinosaurs. The saurischian dinosaurs themselves are divided into two major groups, the Sauropoda morpha, which includes the giant long-necked dinosaurs, and the Theropoda, which includes the iconic Tyrannosaurus rex and Velociraptor. In this video, we are going to look at the Sauropoda morpha, and we're going to take a tour of the earliest of the long-necked dinosaurs before they became the giants in the late Jurassic and Cretaceous periods. Now, this group is primitively called the Protosauropoda. They are an often neglected group of dinosaurs, despite their remarkable success and global occurrence. The earliest members of the Protosauropoda is surprisingly one of the earliest known dinosaurs, the little bipedal dinosaur, Eoraptor. Now, Eoraptor does not look much like a giant brontosaurus-like dinosaur, but give this group of dinosaurs a few million years and they would evolve into the giant long-necked dinosaurs over that time period. The late Triassic was a time of experimentation, and these dinosaurs were the first to get larger, about cow or horse size, before the Triassic-Jurassic boundary. Indeed, globally, these early Protosauropoda expanded out of the late Triassic of Gondwanaland to become found on nearly every continent. The South American Riojasaurus is known from several pretty good skeletons, and they exhibit a longer neck and tail and a more quadrupedal mode of locomotion than we find in Eoraptor. This shift from bipedal animal to a quadrupedal animal is found with these early dinosaurs. Walking with the use of the forearm provides support, allowing these dinosaurs to grow larger. But this also diminishes the use of their hands for grasping food and for defense. The most iconic protosauropod is the widespread late Triassic Plateosaurus. Now, Plateosaurus is best known from southern Germany, but fossils have been found in Africa and Asia as well as Europe. Now, Plateosaurus is known for many complete skeletons discovered by the famous German paleontologist Friedrich von Huen. In the 1920s, he excavated a number of skeletons of Plateosaurus from southern Germany, mostly from the Baden-Württemberg state, from the Trosengren quarry. Now, von Huen was an industrious paleontologist even into his old age, having lived through both world wars. He was an avid hiker and would astonish his colleagues by hiking in his old age hundreds of miles to attend scientific conferences. Now, one of the reasons that Plateosaurus is so well known is because of his hard work, not only to excavate the fossils, but to share his discovery through casts that he made available to museums around the world. Now, Plateosaurus is a rather small dinosaur, about the size of a small horse, with a height of just about a meter. Now, all late Triassic and early Jurassic protosauropods were rather small in size, ranging from goose to donkey to cow-sized dinosaurs. A close relative to Plateosaurus is the early Jurassic Mastospondylus. This dinosaur is known from Asia and Africa, but the best specimens come from the early Jurassic of South Africa, from the Upper Elliot Formation. Now, Mastospondylus was named by Richard Owen from fossils sent to him from South Africa in 1858. But additional fossils have been discovered across South Africa. One amazing discovery is a fossilized egg nest of Mastospondylus, which exhibited hatchlings from South Africa. These baby Mastospondylus are the only known hatchlings of protosauropods. During the Triassic and early Jurassic, the world's continents were connected. The Protosauropoda group of dinosaurs like Plateosaurus are found on nearly every continent. A very Plateosaurus-like dinosaur is found in Asia, called Jungshangosaurus from the early Jurassic. And in Africa, we have Mastospondylus. In South America, we have Riojasaurus. And in Antarctica, we have Glaciosaurus. None have yet been found in Australia, but later sauropods are known in Australia, so they likely were present on every continent. Now, in North America, protosauropod dinosaurs are rather rare, which is likely due to the rarity of rock units from the latest Triassic and earliest Jurassic. One of the earliest dinosaurs from North America is Ankylosaurus, which is discovered way back in 1818 in Connecticut. This little dinosaur was first reconstructed as a bipedal dinosaur, but more recent reconstruction of it has it as a goose-sized quadrupedal dinosaur. Now, Ankylosaurus was a small protosauropod, showing that during the early Jurassic, these dinosaurs did not exhibit very large body sizes. In Arizona, several protosauropod dinosaurs are known, such as Cerasaurus, which again resembles Plateosaurus, showing that these dinosaurs were globally distributed. For many years, Utah, which is home to practically every other group of dinosaurs, lacked any specimens of protosauropod dinosaurs. Then, in 2004, a local historian and artist, Joe Pachak from near Bluff, Utah, discovered some bones in a sandstone while he was looking for petroglyphs. The fossil was later described by Joseph Sinrick and Mark Lewin in 2010 as the first dinosaur from the late Triassic, early Jurassic Navajo sandstone. These were ancient sand dune deposits that had previously been assumed to be barren of dinosaurs. But new dinosaurs have recently been discovered from the formation. Now, they named this little dinosaur Cetad, which is on display in Salt Lake City. Now, Cetad was a small protosauropod dinosaur. Only the forelimbs are known, suggesting that it walked bipedally or only occasionally quadrupedally. All the Protosauropoda have projecting single rows of teeth, sometimes leaf-shaped with jagged margins. Now, none of them developed any specialized ability for chewing their food, and the teeth do not occlude well. Most of the digestion was likely done in the stomach or four stomach chambers, and having a large belly and larger body size might have helped these vegetarian dinosaurs digest their food. The most abundant plants during the late Triassic and early Jurassic were things like toxic ferns and rough conifers, which provided limited sources of food and required specialized digestive tracts to utilize. One controversy that surrounds Protosauropoda is whether they represent a monophyletic or paraphyletic group. Some paleontologists argue that Protosauropoda should be considered as an offshoot of a clade of dinosaurs, with a separate origin from the long neck and giant body size dinosaurs belonging to the group Sauropoda. While other paleontologists argue that the Protosauropoda was a diverse group from which the large long-necked dinosaurs, the Sauropoda, arose from during the later Jurassic period. Nevertheless, the Protosauropoda, despite their smaller size, were a very successful group and much more widespread globally than any other larger-sized dinosaurs like the Ceratopsians. Now, in many ways, the widespread geography of Protosauropoda fossils demonstrates that this group was destined to greatness, to become the group that includes the largest land animals to ever exist. All right, you should now be able to summarize the first group of the Sauropoda morpha, the Protosauropoda, and how their widespread geographic occurrence likely led to their gigantic success in the later Jurassic and Cretaceous periods.